My left shoulder has several anchors in it from two rebuilds. And my right has been reconstructed once and been kind of compromised the last 3 months. A little weakness in certain areas at certain angles.
Stem cells are unique because they utilize your own body's healing potential to recover and repair a joint or a tendon or a ligament that's been bothering you. What we're doing when we use stem cell therapy is we're harnessing those cells that are immature and young, and we're actually sticking them into a problematic area. And that problematic area is actually already calling for help. It's inflamed, it's painful. That's why you feel pain in a joint when it's arthritic, is the body's calling for help and no help is really showing up. So by harnessing stem cell therapy, we can kind of awaken that plasticity and say, hey, I want to be well. This joint wants to heal, it wants to recover. Let's give it the tools that it needs so that it can be plastic and recover.
The stem cells can turn into new tissue, whatever is needed, whether it's cartilage, bone. They pretty much have a blank slate and they can create whatever healing is needed in that particular area.
We had a middle-aged man who is very active and he's injured himself along the way. He's developed some arthritis. He's developed some tendonitis, some bursitis in both shoulders. Most people are choosing stem cell therapy because their arthritis is so advanced that they're due for a joint replacement, but they realize the complications and the problems that go along with joint replacement, and so they're looking for alternative options.
I am having stem cells harvested from adipose and mesenchymal stem cells harvested from my hip.
Whenever we're using adipose cells and fat cells, it actually is a kind of a cellular scaffolding. The PRP is the stimulus that tells the cells what to do. The location, meaning wherever we inject it, so if we're injecting adipose cells into a knee, the knee is saying, hey, I need more ligament, I need more cartilage. And so those stem cells, whether it's adipose or bone marrow, turn into whatever the cell or whatever the joint is asking for.
We use three different methods of harvesting them. We used his own bone marrow, prepared that to be re-injected into his shoulders. We also used PRP, which is a blood source, and we also used his fat cells. So that became a mixture that was injected into his shoulders that can precipitate the healing process.
Stem cell harvest from the hip that I was concerned about before wasn't bad. You don't feel anything. I mean, it's uncomfortable that you kind of feel someone, you know, kind of knocking on your hip, but there's no pain, there's no discomfort. And then the harvesting of the adipose stem cells wasn't uncomfortable at all. I actually expected it to be more uncomfortable than it was. It really wasn't bad. It really wasn't.
The patient should expect to receive certain improvements after surgery. This is not by any means a miracle treatment, so I can't promise that everyone's going to have 100% effectiveness. But what I can say is that most people experience regeneration and improvement in the joint. But because it's a regenerative, active healing technique, that actually patients usually experience more pain after the procedure for about 6 to 8 weeks. By the 6 to 8 week mark, they're actually returning back to where they were before they got the treatment. And then after that 8 week area is when they actually start to show improvement, improved mobility, decreased pain, better range of motion, and all that. And so it is a technique that restores. So it's not like when you go to the orthopedist and you get a cortisone shot or a lidocaine shot, you don't feel better afterwards. You actually feel worse afterwards, but it's because that regeneration is taking place. And if you've ever cut yourself, you know that after the cut happens, it burns, it hurts until the cut is fully recovered. My name is Philip Oubre. I'm a medical doctor in Austin, and this has been a Memorable Reflections production.